this way. But even if we are a little bit frightened, we can also use our inquisitiveness or curiosity and our excitement to take that next step, to ask the next question, and to find our way into a new place, be it a magical wood lit up by a lamppost or a new possibility in our day-to-day lives. So I invite you to just consider what faith feels like for you. What are words that you would describe, that you would use to describe faith? And in the next few moments, as we light the candle, we're going to be inviting you to speak those words out loud. But would you just take a few moments to center yourself in this place and consider what faith is for you as you take some deep breaths and we begin to worship together.
God of the wolf and the lamb, God of the goat and the leopard, we gather here to worship you, you who bring enemies together, you who combine earth and heaven, you who know nothing of impossibility.
Expand our hopes and our imaginations so that new dreams of peace and unity might arise. May the hearing of your word, the singing of sacred songs, and the blessing of this community awaken us anew to your presence.
Today we light the second Advent candle. A faith.
As the candle is lit, We invite the congregation to speak out loud words that describe faith to them.
Source of our faith, you are welcome in our world, in our neighborhood, and in our lives.
We dare to walk in faith.
I'm not Naomi Hunter, but she will be here next week to offer her moment to meet the moment, but I just wanted to speak briefly about that. We've just concluded our season of reminding folks why we're here and that inviting you to give to VPC. This last week, I had a conversation with a consultant who works with churches all over the country, and he said to me, "You know, what I'm finding is that pastors are just so discouraged that after going through the pandemic and everything we've been through the last few years, that nothing has changed." And I said, took a moment and kind of took it back. I said, "You know, I don't feel that way at all. Actually, I'm really proud of how our church is leaning in during this time, really trying to meet the moment boldly, and the ways that we're adapting and shifting and taking seriously our mission statement to be a base camp building a more loving world." So we invite you to give to that and as you consider your end of the year giving and your giving in 2023. Usually on Communion Sunday, we don't have our official Sunday school, but today we'd like to invite any children that would like to go into the nursery, and Carrie's in the back and happy to take them with her to just do some quiet activities there. It's just right across the courtyard here. And so kids, you're welcome to go now or to go later, but that's what you're up to today, and you're also welcome to stay in here and enjoy the beautiful music. I know when I was a little girl and we had music in my church, I loved to watch the percussion section. That was my favorite thing. And then there was also a man who I always sang, and I always said he sings at the bottom of the piano. So I see you basses over there. Those are some of my best memories of being in church. So this is a moment when we stand and we greet each other with the simple word peace, sharing the peace of Christ. And so I invite you to stand, look each other in the eye, maybe offer an elbow or a fist pump or a wave or a peace sign, whatever you'd like. But let's together say, the peace of Christ be with you.
The scripture reading this morning is from Luke chapter 1, verses 46 to 55. And Mary said, "I'm bursting with God news. I'm dancing the song of my Savior God. God took one good look at me, and look what happened. I am the most fortunate woman on earth. What God has done for me will never be forgotten. The God whose very name is holy, set apart from all others. His mercy flows in wave after wave on those who are in awe before him. He bared his arm and showed his strength, scattered the bluffing braggarts. He knocked tyrants off their high horses, pulled victims out of the mud. The starving poor sat down to his banquet. The callous rich were left out in the cold. He embraced his chosen child, Israel. He remembered and piled on the mercies, piled them high. It is exactly what he promised, beginning with Abraham and right up to now." For the word of God in scripture, for the word of God among us, for the word of God within us, thanks be to God.
What does Mary's prayer look like in our world today? It looks like a table that is set for everyone, a table where the high and mighty are brought down to earth and where the lowly are given a place of honor. And so that's what we come to do today, to enact and receive what we have just heard. Someone recently I heard says, we don't take communion, we receive it. It is something that is given to us to nurture us in the ways that we are called to walk in faith in our world. So here is where we live out Mary's vision, a vision of incredible welcome for everyone. In other words, you are welcome here at this table. Would you join me in the response in your bulletin? God is with us. We are not alone. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give our thanks and praise. Let's pray. Oh God, we give thanks for this table and for the way it has been set in our world over and over again for centuries. We pray for this world, that it may continue to truly embody all that this table holds, all of the hope and the faith and the longing of Mary's prayer. And we pray these words spoken by her son as we pray together, our God who is in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For yours is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. On the night that he was betrayed, Jesus sat with his friends around a table and took some bread and broke it and offered it to them, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body that is broken for you." And in the same way, after the meal, he took the cup and he said, "Drink. This is my blood, my very life, poured out for you. Do this in remembrance of me." And he said that whenever we do this, whenever we eat this bread and we drink from this cup, we proclaim a new covenant, a different way of being in the world. We proclaim a way of love, a way of welcome. And so, my friends, this is for you as well. You are invited to take this bread and drink this cup, whether you've never done it before or this is your millionth time. All are welcome. In just a few moments, you'll be invited to come forward here to receive the cup and the bread. We have gluten-free options for those who prefer that and little hermetically sealed cups if you are a little cautious about sharing the plate. So please feel free to take one of those. It has both a little wafer and juice in it, but you're also welcome to take a piece of bread and dip it in the Jews. Choir and orchestra, after you're done singing, you'll be able to go to the back and someone will be there to serve you as well. So these are the gifts of God for the people of God. I'd like to invite our servers to come forward and prepare to be served. And everyone will come forward today.
Thank you.
Would you pray with me? Oh God, we thank you for these gifts. May we remember that we are mirrored in these gifts because your life lives within us. And may they also be what we continue to reach for with hope and faith, to be your presence of love in this world, to receive you just as Mary received your life within her. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Would you stand with me and together let's sing the beautiful Advent hymn, O Come, Emmanuel, number 88, and we'll sing verses 1, 2, 6, and 7. I am so grateful to all of our musicians today, to the instrumentalist, to Barbary on the organ, to the choir, and to our amazing choir director, Roth. Would you join me in saying thank you? It means so much to have you all here, especially after the last two Christmases that we had something last year, but it just wasn't the same, and we still got our masks on, but we're going to do it anyways. So I love this beautiful line that Sarah sang, Christ lives and grows in me. That is the reality that Mary was experiencing and the reality that each of us are invited to as we go out into this world. May you know Christ living and growing in you. Go in peace.